Hello everyone. Hi everyone, this is Ravi and today we are going to start with the core Java sessions. Okay, before that I would like to inform you guys that you must have got the manual, right? You all can hear me, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and you all have the manual, the Salesforce syllabus, I mean the Java syllabus provided by the CVK Tech, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, so I am the instructor who will be covering the module 1, okay? Core Java module 1, I am the instructor who is going to cover the Core Java module 1, and then there are respective trainers who will be covering the other modules, okay? So today we are going to start with the Core Java sessions, where first we will discuss about the history of Core Java. History of Core Java and then few features of it, and then we will learn a simple program, because this is the first class. We'll start with a simple program. And how many of you have the Eclipse installed on your systems? I believe everyone has the Eclipse installed. Is it correct?
No, I do not have.
Okay, so you need to just type in Google Eclipse IDE. I repeat, Eclipse space IDE for Java developers. Okay, and then install the Eclipse version as per your system design. For an example, if you are using Windows 32-bit or 64-bit, based on that you need to choose one of the installation files, and then you need to install it on your system. Okay, you should also have the JDK 1.7 or the latest version of Java Development Kit installed on your machine, then only it will work. Now, as I said, first we will discuss about the history of Java. Okay, we are going to talk about it. Let me just open one of the PPTs. Just give me one moment. Okay, so I hope everyone is there, right? And the session has to be interactive, then only it will help you guys. Okay, so I'm kind of not going to read all the slides. Okay, I'll just brief you about the history of it, and then we will go further. Okay, so Java is one of the object-oriented programming languages, and now you may ask me, what is object orientation? I will discuss it in its features section. Okay, so right now I will start with the history of it. So in January of 1999, there were a few guys like Bill Joy and James Gosling, Mike Schredin, Patrick Nocton, and several others. They met in Colorado to discuss about the softwares, to discuss about one of the projects. Okay, and in which they decided that they are going to create some program. They are going to create some programming language. Then they created the Java, and they developed a new language because it was not there, and they developed a new language. The friends met in Colorado, USA, and then they started developing a new language. And initially, the name, initially the name of Java was Oak, O-A-K. Initially, the name of Java was Oak, but later on it was changed to Java. Why? Because they used to have many cups of coffee while discussing about this project and the new language, and coffee was kind of made of Java at that point in time, and there was something Java beans or something. So then they changed its name as Java because they consumed so many cups of coffee while discussing about it, and that's why the name was changed. And today, if you see the icon for Java, you see that it's coffee cup and the saucer, right? So this is a little brief and kind of history. Nobody is going to ask you, but they may ask you what is the initial name of Java was and how it was changed, and why the icon of Java is a coffee mug or the saucer. Okay, clear so far? Am I clear? Now, okay, good. So now we will discuss about the features of Java. What are the features of it? Okay. One of the main features of Java is it is system independent. Okay, it is a system independent language. It means it can run on any sort of system. It can run on any machine. It's not any. It's not a machine specific language. It can run on any machine. So this is one of the features, right? Apart from this, there are other reasons for you know, it as well, like the portability. What is portability? Portability means whatever the output you see of a program on one machine, Java program on one machine, it's going to be the same on the other machine. So it means it is providing you the facility. You can you know, put your program on any on any of the machines. As I said, it is system independent. It is not going to hurt you in any way, and you can port it anywhere on any machine. So it is system independent. It's a simple language. Why it is a simple language? Because the people who have worked on C and C++, when the Java was developed, when the Java was found, they tried to make it simple. How they make it simple? If you have been able to work on C and C++, they are also the object-oriented programming languages. You can easily work on Java because the syntax of Java is very similar to C and C++. Okay. For an example, it has been a little changed. Like in, you create the classes in Java. You used to create the classes in C++ as well. Right, you have a cout output. That's a system defined output method in C++. Now in Java you have system dot out dot print line or printf methods, which system, these are the system method which will help you to print your values. So this is very similar. When we say it's simple, we compare it with C and C++. In C++ you have functions, in Java you have methods. Okay, why do we say, what is the difference between method and function? Can anyone try to elaborate this for me, if anyone is aware? Okay, no problem. So, okay, at any point, whatever I'm teaching, trying to make you learn, guys. So, at any point you have any question, please ask me. And the session has to be interactive, then only it will benefit you. So what is the difference between method and function? A method is which is created within a class.
Okay.
In C and C++, you can create programs without classes as well. It means you start your program with the main, and then with the main function, okay, there is a main function, main method in any program from where it is, from where the compiler understands there is a compiler which converts your machine language into your code into the machine language just to interpret it, right? And then it gives you the output. So the compiler directly goes to the main method and then it executes the program. So in C++, what you can create programs without classes, without creating the classes. We will discuss about the classes a little later. But in Java, you cannot create any program without classes, right? You will have to create a class, no matter you write all your code under the main, but still you need to have a class. Class is a must. So when you create your methods within the, when you create a function, I mean, within the classes, it's the method, it's not function. And when you are working on a program without the classes and it's still creating a function, that's a function, that's not a method. So method is which is created within a class. Clear? So a method is also a function, okay, which is written in a class. Yeah.
Again, sorry.
A method is a function that is written in a class. Okay, we do not have functions in Java. Instead, we have methods. It means whenever a function is written in Java, it should be written inside the class body. Okay, not in the main body. But if we take the examples of C++, we can write the functions inside as well as outside the class in C++. Clear? Clear to all of you? Okay. If I hear the silence, I will assume that you get it. Okay. So it's simple. One of the features is it's simple. Now the other feature is it's object oriented. I was just discussing about classes, right? So now this is a big concept in because the language is itself. When you go for interviews, the interviewer might ask you, do you know any OOPS language? What is OOPS? OOPS is object-oriented programming language. Object-oriented programs. So, and the first line you start, if somebody asks you if you know Java, you start with the definition. Yeah, I know Java and it's one of the object-oriented programming languages. So, and the next question he shoots that, do you know what is object and what is orientation? How it is object oriented? Can you define it? So it becomes a very genuine and very essential question for any object oriented programming language, be it C, C++ or the Java. So Java is an object oriented programming language. Why? Because Java programs use objects and the classes. Okay, now you may ask me, what is an object? An object is anything that really exists in this world and can be distinguished from others. Whatever you see in this world, that is whatever you can see, that is some kind of object. For an example, a book, a tree, a human being, everyone is an object. Now what is a class? So based on all these the features of all these objects, when you group them under something, for an example, someone who applies his brain and someone who walks, someone who eats, sleeps, right? And so you keep them in one group, and that group can be the animal or the human being, right? So human being is a class and we are the objects, right? Every object has some different feature. For an example, I work for some different organization. My routine is a little different from those of you, and you might do some other work, so you have different features, right? Somebody is, you know, they have, somebody is tall, somebody is short, right? So objects have different features, but we group them under one class. So, and that's how we understand about the classes. A group of objects exhibiting same behavior, okay, exhibiting same behavior, properties or the and the actions will come under the same group. That will be called a class. Now we can also talk that animal is one of the classes where we can keep cats, dogs, lions, human beings and everyone. So animal is a big class, and the objects I was just referring, they all have some different features. Okay, now if you have any question right now, you can ask me, because it's going to, you know, if you don't understand it, it will create problems.
So object is a class is something which models an object, right?
Object is not a class. Object is an object. For an example, which does the
action. No, I mean class is something which models the object, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Okay. So you can have action methods. Okay. You can have properties. So if you define, if I say class is student. Okay. So this is my class. Now a student can have properties. What kind of properties? It can keep a roll number. It can keep some, name.
Name.
School name. Or college name, whatever. Okay, so these are the properties. What are the actions? He goes for admission, right? He obtains marks, so marks calculation. Okay, so these are the action methods, and the variables help you to define their properties, and the action methods help you with their actions. Whatever the actions they perform. Clear so far, everyone?
Yes.
Okay. So we have discussed two features. That is, we have discussed three, four features. For an example, it is system independent, portability, then object orientation, right? It is simple. Now, one of the main concepts, how a program is run in Java. So we will discuss about JVM. What is JVM? JVM means Java Virtual Machine. Anyone has any idea about this? Okay, no problem. So it's the JVM is called the heart of the entire Java program. Why it is called heart of the Java program? Because the execution of the program starts from here, from the JVM. Okay. When you create a class, first it is .java file. When you create a class, first it is .java file. Then .java file is converted into the, in your .java file, the code is into the bytes. Okay, if you understand the computer, you must be aware of bits, bytes, right? This is the size kind of for the computer language. So first it is your Java program is first in the file of .java. Then it is converted into the .class file. Okay. Then the JVM, the Java Virtual Machine, takes the .class file and converts each byte code instruction into the machine language. For an example, you are working on your Windows machine, then you went to some MacBook and you are trying to run your program, then how does that work? Because there is also the JVM, the Java virtual machine, which converts your .dot class file into the machine language in order to interpret your program. When JVM converts the .dot class file into the machine language, it checks for the instruction errors. If there is any instruction error, if there is any instruction error, it will, your program will be rejected. Otherwise, it will be loaded into the subsystem. Otherwise, it will be interpreted and it will give you the output. I'm again going to explain it to you. First of all, you have the .java file. Okay, your .java file is converted into the .class file. Okay, so .class file have the bytecode instructions by the Java compiler. So far clear? .java file, you create the .java file. Why I'm explaining this again and again? Okay, you maybe some of you may be thinking I'm not, you know, teaching any programming today, but the history is important and it's the part of your module, and history covers the features and all, and you need to understand this. These are asked in the interview, so these are the important concepts. Somebody may ask you, what is JVM? You are using Java, you are learning core Java, and you must understand how the program is executed. So .java program is converted into .class file consisting the bytecode instructions by the Java compiler. Now the Java compiler is outside the JVM, and this class file is given to the JVM. Okay, in JVM there is a module that is called class loader subsystem, which performs some functions, like the loader will load the .dot class file into the memory. The loader will load the .dot class file into the JVM, Java Virtual Machine memory, and then it will verify whether all bytecode instructions are proper or not. If it finds any instruction incorrect, then your program will be rejected, or if it finds it's appropriate, it will be running up and through on your machine. Is it clear? Guys, I need your input.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. Cool. I don't hear from everyone. Okay, so these are some milestones which you can read it later on. So which is, I just summarized the history. Okay. Features of Java. JDK and JRE, Java Development Kit, JRE, which will, again you will find something about the JVM, bytecode and JVM, explained, platform independent, application and applets, we will be learning about it later on. Okay, so you can see this here, it goes like this, Java program, Java compiler. Then the virtual machine will take the bytecode. The bytecode will be converted into the interpreted Java interpreted language, and then it will load it here, and then that will be converted into the machine code in order to have the output. Principle of OOPS. Okay, so before that I want to, so and now I assume everyone has installed the Eclipse as of now, correct? Eclipse, shall we go ahead? Everyone done with the Eclipse? Shall we go ahead?
Yes.
Okay.
No, not
yet. Okay. Your Eclipse will look like this. Okay. Your Eclipse will look like this, where you create the programs Okay, so when you run the program, how do you create your class? First of all, you create a package. The package will be collection of so many programs, classes. So how do you create the class, a new class? Go to your package, go to the source file, okay, right click on that, go to new, okay. I have something, some other language installed here, so don't be confused. Go to example, go to the other, okay, and then choose class, next, okay, name your class, let's say the program one, okay, and then there are some modifiers, public modifier. It means we'll be discussing about the modifiers. Public means it is accessible by all the, for an example, in one package there can be multiple programs, right, and then there can be other projects. In one project there can be multiple programs, then there can be other projects in projects. So if our class is public, it can be accessed outside. It can be, if there are multiple programs in one project, it can be accessed by other classes as well. For an example, the concept of inheritance, we will discuss about more about it. Okay, this is a simple program I'm going to create, so just look at it. We will be explaining so many things, discussing about it later on. Then make sure that you have this box checked, public static void main string args. Okay, I'll be explaining it to you as well. Okay, then just click finish. So initially it will look like this. As I said, you cannot have programs without classes. What is the name of my class? Program one. Then I have the main method here. Why we have main method here? This is my main method. Why we have this here? Because the compiler, the moment I execute, the moment I run my program, it directly goes to the main method. Okay, and then it starts the execution from there. Now if I say, so let me explain few things before. You know what is class? I just explained it to you that it's a group of objects, collection of objects, right? What is public? Public means it is accessible outside the project as well. Okay, you have one project, it can be accessed in the other project. This class can be accessed in the other projects as well. There are other modifiers which we will discuss later. Now there is public static void main. What is public? You know that. What is static? Static means which is common to the entire program. Static means if a method or a variable is static, it means it is common to the entire. If a variable is static, it means it is common to the entire programs, and it can be, it doesn't need to be accessed in every other method, but it will be available for every method. It means if I say I have to enter few students record. Now the students belong to the common school. The name of the school is LPS, but the name of the students and their roll numbers are different from each other. I will be entering the roll number for every student, the name for the student, but I will not be entering the school name for every student. Why? Because that is common. So I will keep the school name as static. Now here the main is common to the entire program. Okay, no matter how many classes I am adding to my program and how many variables or methods I have added, the main will be just one. The main will be just one because it is available to the entire program. So that is public static. What is void? Void means empty. Void means empty. It means it's not returning any value. What is a string and these two brackets? It means it is accepting an array. It is accepting a collection of strings. Strings means, when I say the letter A, when I say the letter N, when I say any letter, that is the character. So a string is the collection of letters. When I say apple, apple is a string. Okay, when I say this is my apple, so that's a string. A statement is a string, a word is a string, but a letter is a character. So it is accepting the array of strings. Okay, what is aux? Aux is the variable for that array. Aux is the variable for that collection. Okay, these are basics. That is why I'm explaining, and you need to understand every aspect of any program if you are working with any language. Now this is a simple program. I will go here into the main part and I will say system.out.println. Okay, println, this is my first program. Okay, I will go here, I will click on run. So this is my first program. Okay, this is my output. Okay, is it clear? Guys, is it clear? The program is clear. Anjali, is it clear?
No.
Okay, to Anjali it is not clear. Fine. I will ask, what is the problem? Jeel, there is somebody Jeel, right? Am I pronouncing your name correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it is correct. I understood the program.
Okay, good. Kane? Okay, Kane. That's fine. Good. So as far as, is it going good, Ken, if you are attending?
That's good.
Okay, cool. Snigdha?
Yeah, I got it right.
Vaidehi?
Yeah, it's clear.
Okay. So Anjali, where is the problem? Can you tell me so that I'll be able to explain it to you again?
So this is, first thing is a class, right? The public class program one, it is a class. And what does this public static void, is it a method or else is it an object?
Okay, so public class program, do you understand that part?
Yeah.
Okay. Now you, so your problem is you don't understand what is the main part, right?
Yeah.
So main is a method. Main is a method which is essential in any program. Main is a method which is essential in any program. Why? Because the moment you run your program, the compiler will look for the main part of the program. Okay? The compiler will look for the main part of the program. And why it will look for the main part of the program? Because the execution starts from there. Java is designed in that way. The compiler will look for the main part, and the execution will start from there. Also, there is one more thing. I just explained what is static. Okay, when you have static, I don't want to confuse you. That's why I'm not giving all the concepts right now. So just understand that the main is a method from where the execution starts. Okay. Now, you know what is a string, args. What is public, static, main, void, everything, you understand it here?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, good. So now, there are few things. You can see, I'll explain something to you, which is not mandatory, but I just want you to know that you can have the case, the program comments. If you want to ignore a line, like you can say, and this will not be counted while executing your program by the compiler. So you can say, this is my first program. So the double slashes, the two, double forward slashes means you are ignoring this line. Okay. If you want to ignore multiple lines, then you can use this comment. The forward slash and the star, and then as I said, you want to ignore multiple lines. I want to ignore from till here, so I will again use star and the forward slash. So I have ignored all these. Okay. For documentation, in most of the programs, in in any book or on any website, you see there is a comment like there is a for the documentation purpose they use it like this. This is for the documentation purpose. For an example, let me go back home and let me, so that it will be more clear to you. I'll go here, I'll say this is my first program. Okay. So this is for the documentation purpose. So on at the top of every line you can use this. The good programmers use this so that the if other programmers check your program, they will not be confused. You use this comment. This is, I mean, a style of commenting on every line, and this is used for the documentation. This is a Java documentation common style. All right. So far we have used, we discuss about the history of Java, then we discuss about some features of Java, then we discuss about JVM, then we discuss about a simple program, how to execute, how to write a program. Okay. Now we will be discussing if you have done something with the C++, any one of you, you must be aware that we used to include few files in order to use the cout in your program. In C++, we used to use hash include stdio, which is standard input output, which is a header file, you remember. Then again you can include some other header file, right? So stdio, this we used to use in the C++ language, not in Java. Okay. And then only we use cout and our comment, whatever it is we want as the output on the output screen, because cout exists in a standard input output header file. A standard input output header file is a collection of all the system methods where it will help you to take input, show output, right? In the same way, in Java we don't use include, but we use import. Okay, we need to import files. For an example, if you want to take input in Java, you'll have to import a file, that is java.utility. java.utility, this is a, so what is the difference between the include and import? So when you use include, you used to use include in C++, what it does is it copies the things from its header file and pastes in the program. It goes to the header file, standard input output, and copies the things and it pastes to the program. But import means it will directly access the data from its system, the header file, that is java.utility. Directly it will access, and it will not copy and paste the information in the program. That is virtually done, that is not explicitly you will be seeing that it's copying and pasting, but it is done. So it will not consume memory. In case of C++, where it copies and pastes, in that case, it consumes the memory. So Java helps you to save your memory. There is also one different, more different in C++ and Java. In C++, we used to have the pointer concept, but in Java, there is no such concept. Pointer used to be very complicated, okay? And programmers, you know, used to get confused with the pointers. But in Java, there is no pointer. There is no such concept. Clear so far?
Yes.
Okay. Now, I have explained how to create a program. Okay, now I will ask you guys to create a program. Create a program to add two numbers. Okay, so how do you add? First of all, you will take integers. Integer, you understand, integer is one of the data types. Data type means the kind of type on which you are going to operate. Okay. So you are going to add two numbers. So numbers will come under the integers. Okay. So integers, for integers you write int in Java. Then you will take two integers. X equals to 5 or 6, whatever. And Y equals to 7. Okay. So two integers, right? Now you want to show the output. So you will say sum, you will take another variable. These are the variables. So there is a difference between the, this is the data type, int is the data type, and x is the variable. It means x can have any value. Variable means its value varies. If I say 6 is not a variable, 6 is a constant. Its value will always be 6. It cannot be changed. But whatever the value we assign to x, that will be changed. So x is a variable, its value can be changed, but 6 is a constant, its value cannot be changed. Now I take another variable sum, where I can store my sum, right? The summation of 6 and 7, x and y. So x plus y. Okay, now I'll go to the system.out.println, okay, that is print line, and then I will say sum. The number of brackets you open, the curly braces you open, you also need to close them. For an example, I have opened one here and I have opened one here, the curly braces. I have closed both of these. So the number of curly braces you open, you also need to close them. Now I want you to type this, the same thing in your Eclipse, and check if it's giving you the output. Okay. I'll give you 5 minutes. I want everyone to work on this so that you will be feeling a little confident about it, that you have created your first program today. Okay. I will be away for a moment from the computer, okay? So please work on it. Okay, guys, I'm sorry, I was away. I'm back now. So, any luck? Anyone has tried and it's working? I will start with Anjali. Anjali?
I'm still installing my laptop, have a problem. I'm trying to install Eclipse, just now JDK is installed.
Okay. Okay, Jigen?
Same here, I'm still installing because it's taking too long on my laptop.
Okay, Srigda? Yeah, Ken. Ken, you are saying something?
I got it actually, I just wanted to.
Okay, okay, cool. Srigda?
I've executed it, yeah, I got it.
Okay, good. Vaidehi? Vaidehi?
Sorry, yeah, I'm almost done, I got it.
Okay. Okay, those who have not installed the Eclipse, you can try installing the Eclipse, because without Eclipse, we will not be able to run any program, okay? We can run it using the command prompt, but that's not the way how you learn the programming. You must have the Eclipse installed. So now you know how to write a simple program, and let's see how to execute a program using the objects, okay? As I said, that you can have so this was a program, you must have noticed that we directly went to the main part of the program and then we tried to execute it, okay? But we are not doing anything in the class, okay? We are not doing anything in the class. We can try to execute the information from the class as well, but for that we need to have some properties from action methods, okay? So for an example, if I say go back here in my program and I want to add two numbers, okay, I will say int x, int y, okay, then I have int sum, okay, and I have a method void display. This is how you write your methods. Method will have its body. When I say method body, when I say class body, it means they have the curly braces open and closed, okay? So I will say sum equals to x plus y, okay, and then I will say this is the sum of x and y plus sum. Okay, now if I execute my program once again, it is not giving me the sum. It is not giving me the sum because I have created the action method. There are a few variables in my program for the properties, but I am not accessing them. In order to get them executed, I need to access them, and for that I need to create an instance. I need to create an instance of the class. How do we create the instance of the class? You enter your class name first, program one, and this is your object variable. I'm just saying obj, you can have anything. This is your reference variable obj. Then you have a keyword new program one. So this is how you create instance of your class, okay? This is how you create instance of your class and then you access. your methods. So obj dot display. Obj dot display. Now the obj, the moment I run my program, it will first print this is my first program, then the compiler will look for the object. So it will find that the object is obj, then it will find the obj is referencing the display method. Okay, so the moment it will find that the it is pointing to the display method, it will directly go to the display method and execute the sum. Okay, now let's execute it once again. Do we have some value? Do I have assigned some value? I have not assigned any value to x and y. That's why it's giving 0. So if I say x equals to 6, y equals to 7, so this is my first program, this is the sum of x and y, 13. Clear? How do we access the, how do we instantiate, how do we create the instance of the class? Clear to all of you?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So tomorrow, write some programs where you have the variables for the properties and the action methods are there in your program. Then create the instances of your classes and then access them and then see how it works. A class can have multiple instances created. For an example, I have just created one instance of this class. You can have multiple instances created for multiple values, for multiple calculations. Okay, so I have just used display method to show the sum of x and y. You can use another method to display the subtraction. You can use another method to display the division, right? Or for any other calculation. Okay, so so for the simple interest, you can write a program for simple interest. Just giving you one task, write a program to find out the simple interest. So simple interest, how will you find the simple interest? You will have the principal amount, you will have the rate, you'll have the rate, the principal amount, and then you will have the time, and then you will be calculating the simple interest. How do you calculate the simple interest? The formula is principal into rate into time divided by 100. Okay, and then create an instance of the class and then access it. Clear to all of you?
Yes.
Okay, cool. That's a simple program. So first of all, those who have not done anything today, like who have not the Eclipse installed, install the Eclipse and then work on the programs that we have discussed today. They are the simple programs. Start with those programs and then go ahead with the task that I gave you today. So this is all for today. Any questions?
Yeah.
Okay guys, so good day to all of you. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.